Hi, my name is Kritika and today I'm going to tell you a story about my life through some mediocre drawings and with the help of some photos. The story begins on 26th Feb 1993 when I was born to my parents Sharad and Anupama in a city called Vellore. I was born into a really awesome family and lived with my parents, grandparents and also my great-grandparents. I was a happy and chubby kid and my family lovingly called me Kiki. A lot of you know me as a traveler now, but I took my first ever flight when I was only 3 months old to meet my grandparents in Delhi. When I was just a year old, my parents took me to a beach a few hours away from our house in Mahabalipuram, and it's safe to say I've been a beach bum ever since then. My dad has been working at our family business called Bombay Anand Bhavan, where we sell sweets and other things, so I basically grew up eating a lot of mithai and still have a very big sweet tooth. My cousins Shweta Didi and Prasid lived close to my house, so I used to hang out and play with them all the time. In fact, Prasid and I are the same age, so we started school together, and here's a photo from our first day at school. Vellore was a small place surrounded with hills and mountains and lots of greenery, so growing up, I spent a lot of time around nature. We would go hiking and I absolutely loved swimming and being around water. My mom is from Delhi, so my Nana, Nani and all my Mausis lived there, and I've spent every summer of my life in Delhi being pampered by my family because I was the first kid on my mom's side of the family. My parents are huge fans of traveling, so the travel bug bit me at a very young age. Whenever we could, my dad would take us on these short trips around Vellore. We traveled quite a bit in Tamil Nadu and Kerala, and when I was 4.5 years old, we went on a trip to the Maldives, which was my first time traveling abroad. Apparently, I had typhoid then, but my parents decided to take me anyway, and it was such a fun trip. I have so many awesome memories from my childhood and all my trips. When I was about 5.5 years old, my brother Vikram was born. Before he was born, I told my parents I wanted a sister, but when Vikram came along, I was so happy and excited that I didn't care he was a boy. Growing up, I was a very good student. In fact, I almost always topped my class, and I was also into sports, theater, and dancing. I even learned Bharatanatyam as a kid. Also, I think I wanted to grow up and be an actor for the longest time. Anyway, my childhood was a lot of fun. I'm one of those kids that loved school, and I had friends to hang out with, and we traveled quite a lot, so it was amazing. I used to really look forward to my summer vacations in Delhi so I could hang out with all my cousins. We also traveled to Thailand, Malaysia, and Singapore this one summer, and that was my second time traveling abroad. My dad was super into photography, so growing up, I kind of developed a passion for it as well and got my dad to teach me how to use a DSLR. After 10th grade, I decided to take up commerce, maths, and economics. I did really well in 12th grade. I even topped the district in my stream and got into Lady Shri Ram College in Delhi, where I studied economics honors. Also, this is the same college my mom studied at too, so that was really cool. Before college, I went on an incredible trip to Australia with my parents and brother, where we went snorkeling in the Great Barrier Reef, among other things. So when I was 17 years old, I moved to Delhi for college, and that was my first time living away from home all by myself. Actually, let's back up a bit. I forgot to talk about my love life. So when I was in school, like any other teen, I started dating this guy and we moved to different cities for college, so we sort of had this long distance thing going on. So anyway, college was a completely different world for me. I lived in a paying guest accommodation where I shared my room with a girl named Caroline, who's from Nagaland. And in my first year of college, I met some of my closest friends, Kritika, Snigdha, Shivika, Sanya, Anchal, and Ashna. The friends I made in LSR are like family to me, and I'm so glad to have met them. The first year of college was quite fun. I'll be honest, I used to bunk some of my morning lectures because I was a late riser and I'd get my friend Shivika to give me proxy attendance, but somehow at the end of the year, I managed to score really well. I remember my pocket money in college was just 2500 rupees or something, and I had to manage my commute to college, my food, shopping, everything in that money, and I think that's what made me so good with money now. I tried a lot of new things in college. I was a part of a few model UNs. I used to volunteer at an animal shelter in Delhi. I started going for dance classes and learning street jazz, and overall this was such a fun year and I loved being in college. At the end of first year of college, something devastating happened. My boyfriend at the time passed away in a car crash, and I honestly felt like my whole world came crashing down around me. I had never seen death this close before, and this whole incident pushed me into depression, though at the time I didn't really know I was depressed. I lost all motivation in life, lost my appetite, and though I was smiling on the outside because I didn't want to worry anyone, I was feeling so empty and lost from inside. I couldn't process how someone who I'd spoken to just a few hours ago didn't exist anymore, and this whole phase of my life lasted about 2 years and was a very dark time for me. Back then, I really didn't know what depression meant, so I didn't realize I was depressed, but I think the people around me sort of knew and helped me deal with it in their own way. I also started reading a lot of self-help books because I didn't want to feel the way I did, and over time, I eventually got out of depression and started to feel happy again. I'm not sure what exactly made this happen, and this change didn't really happen overnight, but I truly believe time heals everything and you just have to take life one day at a time. Honestly, I wasn't sure I should include this part in my video, but this was such a huge part of my life and has shaped me in so many ways. Although I was depressed, I did have some amazing times during college in those 2 years. I was living with my friend Shivika, I went on a college trip to Udaipur with my friends, and I still think of college as the best years of my life thus far because of my friends. Although I'm not sure I actually enjoyed economics as much as I thought I would, I was super confused about what to do after college, if I should go on and get a master's degree or if I should work for a bit. I eventually decided to work. I got a job as a financial analyst in Mumbai, and on my last day of college, I had to say bye to all my friends and move to Mumbai. Yes, I had to start working immediately. I didn't even get a single day off after college. I was excited about this new adventure though. I'd never been to Mumbai before and I knew zero people there, but I wanted to be independent and live my own life, so I was excited about that. My plan back then was to work for a few years and then go to B school abroad. The first month of this job involved a rigorous training. There were some days where I'd be working on an assignment till 7 a.m. and was expected to be back for training at 9 a.m. So yeah, it was quite stressful, but I was still enjoying learning new things. I made new friends, but I still didn't have a house yet. I was staying in a hotel that the company put me up in, and I barely had any time to go apartment hunting. Luckily, one of my college friends, Sneha, moved to Mumbai and we found an apartment together, which wasn't very nice to say the least. Also, I had no idea what Mumbai was like. I moved during monsoons and it was constantly raining, which I hated. The houses were tiny and it was just so different from Delhi. I also realized I wasn't enjoying my job at all. I had friends at work, but the work itself was so monotonous and I just didn't see myself living my life that way. My work hours were crazy, I barely had a life, and on weekends I was so exhausted that I'd just spend my time sleeping. I felt like if I didn't quit this job then and try something else, I'd be too comfortable doing this, so I decided to quit my job and I moved back home to Vellore to figure out what to do next. I always wanted to try a creative field, so I decided to get a job in advertising. I worked for this company called Lolintas in Bangalore and really enjoyed the work. I made a lot of good friends there. The work hours were crazy here too, but I was liking the work, so I didn't really mind. But despite that, I had a deeper feeling of dissatisfaction, which I couldn't figure out why it was happening. But nonetheless, I liked advertising and I still wanted to go to B school eventually, for which you need 16 years of education. So I decided to do a 1-year master's in advertising and marketing communications at Xavier Institute of Communications in Mumbai. So yes, I was back in Mumbai, and this time I actually fell in love with the city. I lived in a paying guest accommodation with an amazing view of the sea, and the landlord was so sweet and he used to take us sailing, which was amazing. I also made some awesome friends here. I then went on to work at 2 more jobs, one in digital marketing and one as a marketing manager at Camlin, the stationery brand. During my third job, I was just bored and wanted a creative outlet, so I decided to start a blog. It was called Blog of the Things, and I write about all kinds of things, basically whatever I felt like. This is also around the time I started posting on Instagram, and I totally loved creating content and sharing it with the world. Then eventually, a year after that, when I was working at Camlin, I decided to start a YouTube channel, and that completely changed my life. When I started, I had no idea how to edit videos, so one of my friends taught me the basics and I learned the rest online. The joy I got from uploading my first video, I can't put that to words. Even though no one really watched it except for my family and friends, I loved making videos so much that I kept going. Every weekend, instead of going out and hanging out with friends, I'd create and edit videos at home. Initially, I was a bit embarrassed to tell people I made YouTube videos, so I wouldn't really talk about it much and I'd just play it down and act casual, but I don't think anything at that point made me as happy as this did. Also, this was when I had previously decided to start applying to B schools, but somehow my heart just wasn't in it. I had two options: work and apply to B schools, or just quit my job and give this whole YouTube thing a real shot. I didn't really dislike my job as such, so this was a difficult decision to make. But I somehow didn't like the fact that I was working for someone else, and the whole time I felt like a fish out of water. I couldn't get myself to be passionate about that, so after a lot of sleepless nights and a lot of thinking, I decided to quit my job and give YouTube a shot. I only had around 700-800 subscribers then, so I really had no good reason to be doing this, but I did have a decently sized audience on Instagram, and I'd occasionally get brand deals here and there, so I felt like this whole social media world did have some good scope. So in 2017, I quit my job and became a YouTuber. During the four jobs I had, I barely got to do any travel. All my holidays were spent going home. So once I quit my job, I decided to get back to traveling for a while because I missed it so much. I went on an epic trip to Thailand with my friend Sayogita and vlogged that whole trip. I subsequently traveled to Varanasi, Kerala and Goa. I was actually mostly traveling during this time, but still paying rent in Mumbai, which if you know anything about Mumbai, is very high. So I took the difficult decision of leaving my life in Mumbai, saying bye to all my friends and moving back home with my parents in Vellore. I'd been living alone since I was 17, so this was quite a change, but I really liked it. I was mostly traveling and it felt so nice to be living with family again and eating amazing home-cooked meals. During this time, I traveled to Vietnam with my brother, went to Arunachal Pradesh and Assam, Iceland, Ladakh, Bali, Singapore, Hong Kong, and Dubai. I also did a few trips with my friends. My channel went from 5,000 to 100,000 subscribers, and I started making decent money through YouTube. After living at home for a year, I decided it was time to move back to Mumbai for better work opportunities. I moved into an apartment all by myself for the first time ever, and I'm now living a life that I'd never even dreamed of. Since then, I've worked with so many brands and tourism boards, got into travel for free, and I'm now making more money than I did at my job. And best of all, I now work for myself. And I have you guys to thank for this. Your support and encouragement really means the world to me. So this is the story of my life thus far, and honestly, this just feels like the beginning. We have a long way to go and I'm super excited to see what comes next. Thank you so much for watching this video. As always, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button. You can click here to watch other videos of mine. Give this video a like, comment and let me know what you thought of it, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!